science and technology is probably the most, well, for me, the most important aspect of any society. I think it makes that society, it determines the level of significance, the level of wealth. Like, science and technology is so important, and right now with all the competing nations, and I think it's imperative that our students realize this and that we continue to grow in the science and technology fields. When I was a little girl, I really was curious about how things worked. I would like to take things apart, put them back together. When things broke, I would always troubleshoot them with my dad, trying to figure out what was wrong and if we could fix it. He's an electrical engineer, and he was always trying to fix things with duct tape and wiring out of the garage. I wasn't the smartest person, but I liked to learn and I worked hard, so it helped me do well. But I took College of Southern Maryland classes while I was a senior in high school. I think CSM gave me an insight to what college work would be like, and it motivated me to want to do better. Some nights I didn't sleep in college because you're up studying or you're up doing assignments, and it's painful, and you cry, you miss home. My dad used to always say to me, work hard now or work hard later. I think people need to remember that whatever their degree's in, it's not gonna say what they're gonna do in their career field. It's just gonna help them excel and do better because they know how to learn. I was going to be a doctor, and in the back of my mind, I always loved engineering and physics and science, so, and math. So I actually got my undergraduate degree in math. During that process, I got an internship with NSWC, and it pretty much changed my whole course of action. And it was a military application, which I never really thought of getting involved in. But knowing that you're actually researching technologies that will benefit the warfighter, which in turn will secure our country. And I mean, all this, the whole 9/11 was happening, and Homeland Security was a huge deal when I actually entered into my internship. It was lasers. I just want to say lasers, lasers, lasers. They're the future. They are the future of everything. I mean, we see them more and more with, you know, laser hair removal. They're in our grocery scanners. Everything involves lasers nowadays. And when I started this internship, I had no idea I was going to be working with lasers. And I was, and they were high power lasers, and we were blowing stuff up and shooting through materials. We start from the smallest, the low level things, like what kind of materials are we going to be shooting? What kind of atmosphere are we going to be shooting through? With the data that we collect through all the experimentation, we can give that to the M&S guys, the modeling and sim guys, and they can put it into their programs, and that actually helps us determine future tests. It just can be very complicated, so you have to really learn how to analyze your data and find the best ways, and know that you might not always come to this awe moment, like, this is why it happens, but you're working towards that goal. Most of my coworkers are men. However, since I've started, there's three females on my team now. One of them is a mentor. She's been in the field for a good 20 years. She's awesome. And I think having her as a role model has really helped me realize that I can do this too. You don't have to be a man, you don't have to be a geek, you don't have to be a nerd to be involved in science and technology. You can be who you are, exactly who you are. There's so much to learn out there, there's so much to know. It's not possible to learn everything. So you just have to have an open mind in that sense, where you just need to want to learn, but don't expect yourself to know everything. Indulge yourself in all of the disciplines, as they say, from whether it's biology, science, math, like just all the different fields, and be open and to learning everything. And in that journey, you'll find what really sparks your interest and what you're good at.